Hey everyone, I'm Sugandha and you're watching Ready with HR and I hope so you all are well. And yes, welcome back to this recruiter workshop. This is day 6 and today we are going to learn how to build a strong employer brand. Okay, but before that, let's get started with a quick recap from day 1 to day 5. If you don't want to see this, yes, you can skip around 2 minutes. Okay, so first on day 1, we have discussed about introduction to recruitment, what all we have discussed in recruitment, what is recruitment, what is recruitment process, and who is a recruiter, what are the roles and responsibilities of recruiter, importance of recruiter, and what are the current trends and challenges faced during this recruitment process. On day 2, we have discussed about understanding job requirements, how we can understand job requirements, what are actually job requirements, how we can align these job requirements. On day 3, we have discussed sourcing strategies. Yes, what all sourcing techniques are there? First of all, what are sourcing strategies? And yes, advantages and disadvantages attached to each sourcing technique. On day 4, we have discussed about candidate screening and evaluation. How we can screen the data we have sourced on day 3 and what evaluation process we can adopt, right? Next, on day 5, we have discussed about interesting session, and that was interview techniques, what all interview techniques we can adopt and interview a candidate. Today, we are going to discuss about building a strong employer brand, how we can build a strong employer brand. In this, we are going to discuss 3 things. First is what are the strategies for enhancing employer brand visibility. Next, how we can create a positive candidate experience. And yes, what is the importance of employer branding? Okay, so let's get started. Make sure to subscribe this channel if you're watching me for the very first time. And yes, do hit that cute notification bell icon so that you could get my updates later on as well. And yes, I have a request. Please, if you haven't watched these sessions from day 1 to day 5, please check out from the pinned comment. You can find HR Recruiter Workshop. This is in Hindi also, in English also. You can check from the pinned comment. Okay, we have effective strategies that can be implemented. So first is online presence. Now, online presence, how we can do this? So through company website. Ensure the career page is engaging and informative. I always say that if you're posting any job posting on any job portal, please make sure to post it on website also, so that the candidate can tell you both the things. Include testimonials, videos and stories that showcase the company culture, values and employee experiences. That should be engaging. It should have a proper presence. Social media, use platforms like LinkedIn, Facebook, Insta, X to share content that highlights the company's achievements, employee stories, and yes, day-to-day activities. Engage with followers by responding to comments and messages. You must respond to their comments, to their messages, to their queries. Even a small thank you works best. Next is content marketing. Blogs and articles. Now here you can publish content on industry related topics, company updates and thought leadership. Highlight employee achievements and company initiatives. Now you have to publish some articles, blogs. You can check in your industry what kind of topic is prevailing, like in market some news is related to some technology, is there automation, is there. So what you can do, you can create an article or a blog related to the latest things happening in the market. Yes, that will attract the employees who are interested in that industry, people who are interested in that industry news, and they will get attracted towards it. Next is videos. Create and share videos that provide a glimpse into the company culture, office environment, and yes, employee experiences. Virtual tours, behind the scenes looks, and employee interviews can be particularly engaging. You can create nice interviews that, you know, that videos should not be like 10 minutes, 15 minutes or 20 minutes. They will be boring. You can do a short video. You can create a short video, maybe up to 1 minute or 2 minute max. Max, you can stretch to 3 minutes. Don't make it a big story, a big video that becomes boring. Okay, means short videos are really helpful. Yes, if you want to show this like virtual do's behind the scenes, it could be like stretched to 5 minutes or 10 minutes max, but not more than that. Especially employee experiences and all should be of short duration. Next is employee advocacy. Now, what is this? Here we are going to discuss two things: referral programs and employee testimonials. Now, you have to encourage employees to refer candidates and promote the company within their networks. But here, when you are encouraging the employees, you have to recognize and reward successful referrals also. If you want to promote this culture, if you want to establish this referral program, then yes, you have to recognize it and you have to reward on the successful referrals. Then only this process can continue. Then only employees will refer the candidates. Okay. Next is employee testimonials. You have to share authentic testimonials from employees about their experiences and growth within the company. Again, this video, this testimonial can be a short one, so that audience doesn't get bored, and these can be in the form of written stories. Yes, even the written stories should be briefly written, should be in short, and it could be a para kind of thing as well. Videos or yes, social media posts. You know, too much lengthy posts become boring and people does not get attracted towards it, right? Next is community engagement. Now here, yes, we are going to discuss two things: corporate social responsibility, partnership and sponsorships. Now you have to highlight the company's corporate social responsibility initiatives and community involvement. It's important to be socially responsible and show that how the company gives back to the community and support social issues. Because yes, you can't work in isolation. When you are working, you have to give it back to the society as well. You are getting the resources from the society. So if you think morally, ethically, then also you should be responsible and you should understand your responsibility that yes, you have to give back. Next is partnerships and sponsorships. Again, partner with educational institutions, industry associations and local organizations. Sponsor events, webinars and workshops to increase brand visibility and demonstrate industry leadership. Now here I am talking about is sponsoring the events. It could be that yes, you don't have that much budget, so yes, initially you don't need to do that, and you can sponsor a part of the event. Like if there is a memento distribution in that event, so you can sponsor the memento part or anything which your budget allows. Okay, so yes, this is like you need to partner with educational institutions and industry associations. This will definitely help. Now this is about what are the strategies for enhancing employer branding visibility. Now let's understand about how we can create a positive candidate experience. Now this candidate experience helps a lot. This is a crucial for maintaining and enhancing employer brand. This is actually the true feedback from the mouth of the candidate, and this starts from whenever he or she saw job posting of your company and till onboarding, and even it continues when the candidate is at your place, at the workplace. Even if we have hired that candidate, then also this candidate experience continues, because they communicate to other people in their circle and to the places, to the social media platform about the experience. So yes, clear communication is important. In the job descriptions, you must write clear and concise and accurate job descriptions. Ensure that they reflect the roles, responsibilities and required skills and company culture. This should be clear. Next is timely updates. Keep candidates informed about their application status at each stage of the hiring process. Okay, a lot of people, again, a lot of candidates call me, message me that, ma'am, we have given interview and we are not getting response. You know, HR is not picking our call, interviewer is just ignoring, and we have done messages at different places, at LinkedIn, Insta. Everywhere we are following up, but that person is not taking the call and we are not aware about the process. Okay, so don't do this. Prompt communication shows definitely respect for their time, for candidates' time and interest. Fine. नेक्स्ट इज एफिशिएंट हायरिंग प्रोसेस. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड फॉर एफिशिएंट हायरिंग प्रोसेस यू हैव टू स्ट्रीमलाइन द एप्लीकेशन एंड यू हैव टू डू रिस्पॉन्सिव इंटरव्यूइंग. व्हाट इज अ स्ट्रीमलाइंड एप्लीकेशन? अगेन सिंप्लीफाई द एप्लीकेशन प्रोसेस. इट शुड नॉट बी अ कंबर्सम प्रोसेस लाइक योर एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म लास्ट फॉर 4, 5, or 8, 10 pages, and that's too lengthy. You have asked some tricky questions, or you have asked too much personal details. Ensure it is user friendly and doesn't require unnecessary steps or information. Okay, this you have to keep in mind. Next is responsive interviewing. Schedule interviews promptly and respect the candidate's time. You must understand that if you will make this process too much lengthy, candidate will move. They won't appear for interviews. They will drop down. They will, you know, withdraw their application as well. So provide clear instructions and expectations for each interview stage. Okay, if you have decided that yes, this interview process will last for 1 month and it has several stages, like it has 5 or 6 stages, please communicate that stages when you have already planned to the candidates with a proper mail, so that they are aware, oh, this is a 1 month process, oh, this is a 2 month process. Okay, they must be aware. Next is candidate respect and engagement. Again, personalized interaction is important. You have to address the candidates by name and personalized communications. This creates definitely a personalized communication. Make them feel valued and appreciated throughout the process. Whenever you feel that yes, this is fine, you are getting your questions, or even a small thank you and greeting serves a lot. So constructive feedback is important. Provide constructive feedback to candidates who are not selected. This will help them to understand their strengths and areas for improvement and leaves a positive impression of the company. Here I'll give a disclaimer that please ask your manager, boss, or anyone, supervisor, who is leading this recruitment process, that what kind of feedback you have to provide and how to provide it, because not every candidate takes the feedback in a positive manner. So you have to provide the feedback in a constructive way, in a proper manner. So please make sure to ask about this feedback with your manager, supervisor, boss. Okay, next is onboarding process. Yes, warm welcome and yes, ongoing support is important. Create an engaging onboarding process for new hires. They must feel that yes, they are working since long with the company, or means making them comfortable. Not only that, okay, they are working since long. Yes, they are being welcomed, they are being introduced. They must feel valued, respected. Provide them with the necessary resources. This is important. Don't do this, okay, when the candidate will come, then we will arrange things. No, this is such a bad idea. Even if you are with the small organization, I have seen people working in the small organization, small level organizations. They feel, okay, only one person is in the department, or two people are there in the department. Okay, let him come and then we will arrange things before him. Please don't do this. Please arrange these resources pre-hand. Next is, yes, introduce them properly and provide support so that they integrate smoothly. Next is, yes, it's not a 1 day process or a 1 week or 15 days process. You have to provide them ongoing support, offer continuous support and check-ins during the initial months to ensure new hires are settling in well and have the resources they need. It important. Okay, please make sure to make this a practice that yes, any candidate should be treated in the same way. Whoever the candidate is, lower level, middle level, senior level, these things we have to understand and we have to keep in mind. Fine. Next is, now we have already understood about the employer branding lot, but yes, let's quickly understand about the importance. Obviously, we know that employer branding plays a critical role, because if there is a brand, people get attracted towards it and they apply. So if we have to attract and retain top talent, this branding is important. And let's discuss some points again in detail why it's important. First of all, yes, attracting talent, competitive advantage. A strong employer brand differentiates company from competitors, and it really helps to attract highly quality candidates who are seeking not just a job, but an organization that align with their values and career aspirations. Not only, you know, they're not only looking for a job, especially the middle level people and the senior level people, they're looking for a organization for long-term association. Okay, freshers, yes, freshers do experiments, they join the company, they learn, they move on to, you know, different companies. But yes, if you are looking for high quality candidates, even at the fresher place, then yes, they do attract with the brand. Passive candidates, yes, again, an appealing employer brand can attract passive candidates who are not actively looking for a job, but yes, are open to opportunities from well-regarded employers. Yes, passive candidates are those candidates who are not looking for jobs right now, but yes, they are looking for networking, and it could be that after 6 months, 3 months or 1 year, whenever they are looking for a job, they will apply. So yes, they can be suitable candidates in the future. Next is retaining talent, employee engagement, and what is ambassadorship. Now, what is employee engagement? We have discussed about this several times. I have a separate session on this. Employees, you know, who are proud of their company's brand, are more engaged and motivated. They feel satisfied. They feel, okay, this is my work. This is not company's work. They're likely to be more productive and stay with the company longer. If they're satisfied, they're engaged, they feel motivated, they feel connected. Yes. They will be more productive. Next is ambassadorship. Now, I have used this word because engaged employees become brand ambassadors. How? Because they start promoting the company to their networks, which further enhances the employer brand. Yes, they are not brand ambassadors actually. We have not given them that honor of being a brand ambassador. But yes, because they feel satisfied, they always talk about their company at different social media platforms, face-to-face with the people, one-to-one conversation. Yes, obviously, they are promoting our company, okay? So, yes, this is a vicious circle. You have to put ongoing efforts, then only you can get this. Next is cost efficiency, reduced hiring cost and lower turnover. A strong employer brand definitely reduces the need for extensive recruitment, marketing and advertising. The moment you post a job posting, yes, you will get lots of replies. Candidates are more likely to seek out and apply to companies with a strong reputation. Oh, that company has a great brand. That company is a branded company. That company has posted a job. People will apply in thousands. That's the case. So, yes, reduced hiring cost. Next is lower turnover. Enhanced employee retention due to a strong employer brand reduces the cost associated with high turnover, such as recruitment, training and onboarding expenses. Yes, people don't want to leave the job because yes, they are working with a brand. They don't want to leave the job. And here comes the lower turnover. We don't have to incur these expenses like recruitment expense, training, onboarding expense again and again on the new hires, because yes, my employees are not resigning. I have to hire only for the candidates or only for the positions which are new. Okay, that is cost efficiency. Here with this, we have seen strategies, and here we have seen how we can create a positive candidate experience and importance of employer branding. So if I have to summarize, yes, by focusing on this importance of employer branding, implementing strategies to enhance visibility and creating a positive candidate experience, companies can build a strong employer brand that attracts and retains top talent, enhances employee engagement, and ultimately contribute to, yes, what's organizational success and people success. Okay, the people who are connected with us, the employees who are connected with us, their growth as well. Okay, so I hope so. This was helpful. This is day 6, building a strong employer brand. Next, we are going to discuss about the diversity and inclusion in hiring. That will be day 7. Please be here. That is really an important session. I will definitely give you tools and strategies for minimizing bias in hiring and how we can promote this diversity in sourcing and selection process. So if it's helpful, please do let me know in the comment section. Until next video, all the very best. Stay happy, stay safe. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.